Leadership. Flashing of brilliance and excellence.
They shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. They shine bright everywhere we go. They shine bright everywhere we go.
Leadership. Impacting society with peace, love, and hope. Shining the light for America is the James A. Hendrick School of Leadership. Magnifying the light, reflecting the sun, the S-O-N, Jesus Christ, our Lord. You know, precious diamonds coming from him. Anyway, today's topic, and I'm doing this to avoid, because I'm noticing on some of the news shows, it's easy for me to get mad. Because of all the leftist propaganda out there, and really both parties nitpicking at such a crucial time at each other, because it's such a crucial time in the election. How can someone be called a conservative federalist? You know, I know many pro-lifers don't like Trump because he's giving the abortion issue to the states. Many people should know this. I'm gung-ho pro-life. Okay? But I don't think it should be something that should be a federal issue. I think it should be left to the states like it was originally. If we keep playing tiddlywinks like we are, we're only giving in to the liberals, because the more we yell we want a federal case, the more they yell they want a federal case. Now, that being said, we're going to cover some news stories. Let's go to CBN News and get this phone to cooperate. All right. And while we're at it, let me put my phone on Do Not Disturb, so I can do my content freely. Here's another story. Israel strikes Hezbollah after a Passover rocket attack. I gotta say, good for them. Good for them. Let's hear from CBN News.
No peace for Passover in Israel. Hezbollah and the IDF exchanged attacks in the north, while down in Gaza, Israeli forces continue preparations for the push against Rafah.
Well, here at home, a bill to send more aid to the Jewish state is on its way to the president's desk. Meanwhile, anti-Israel protests on college campuses continue to spread. CBN's Julie Stahl reports.
While Congress has approved another $26 billion in aid to Israel, pro-Palestinian protests are cropping up on campuses across America. Since they began at New York's Columbia University last week, the demonstrations have spread to schools from coast to coast, some becoming violent. In Cal Polytech in Humboldt, students pushed and screamed at police. At Columbia, Mayor Adams warned of outside agitators stirring up violence. The school has shut down on-campus classes, and Jewish students say they fear for their safety.
I'd say the majority of my friends, especially Jewish friends, feel a sense of insecurity at this time.
Speaking to CBN's Gary Lane,
I gotta say this, okay? This ain't a federal matter, this is a state matter. Those of you who are state authorities, if they're not able to peaceably protest, lock them up, round them up. Okay? And Biden is such a weakling, he's feeding into this unrest. Here's another story. Abraham Accords put to test. Okay. Now, we're not going to cover. We're going to try. For some reason, this phone is not cooperating, and I want to be able to report. Police don't have an answer yet to Mendisa's cause of death. Oh, man. This is sad. This is sad. I'm going to try to find some other. And my phone. It does not like cooperating, and I didn't want it to descend into a vent, but I may have no choice. I'm having a hard time finding a good. Okay, here's a possible good story here. Florida Governor DeSantis signs law allowing chaplains in public schools, ACLU and satanic push back. I can't believe this idiocy. The states have a right to some self-determination. And these libs, I swear. Now, yes, I am a conservative federalist because I believe in states' rights. Because what we saw during COVID was pathetic. And once again, I'm trying to not cover a bunch of things regarding foreign policy. The stupid phone does not like to cooperate. Stop. Alright, this news story we'll cover.
About 27 miles off the Atlantic coast here in Virginia Beach, the nation's largest wind farm is currently under construction. Pretty soon, that beautiful view will be overtaken by roughly 200 wind turbines, which is something neighbors tell me Dominion Energy allegedly lied to them about when first pitching the project.
They lied. That's all there is to it. They lied.
Neighbors living close to work along the coastline say they had no idea they would suffer from wind farm construction.
It's literally making us crazy.
This is torture to me. I have been tortured nonstop for 3 weeks or more. I am literally a human tuning fork.
Neighbors say their homes are suffering as well due to cracked foundations.
For about 4 months, we've been experiencing our house shaking, loud noise. We've been woken up at night.
There are going to be frustrations, and that's why we want to have meetings like this for the community to come out and share those frustrations with us and figure out a way to move forward.
Construction will continue for several months, leading up to the assembly of some 200 turbines in the Atlantic.
This is one of six projects approved by the Biden administration. The U.S. plans to build upwards of 190 wind farms nationwide across every coastline.
Talk about hypocrisy. You know who should be in charge of wind farms? Not the Biden administration. Not the federal government. That should be a matter of private energy. Private companies. Now, I consult with a company that is involved in this matter of, well, frankly, energy, affordable energy, either by main electric power or even solar. I believe in renewable energy, but not for the same reasons that the liberals do. We have a right. We have a right. To think about this. We have a right to self-determination and a capitalist market system. Here's one last bit of news from CBN News.
About 27 miles off the Atlantic coast here in Virginia.
We just looked at this. Crazy phone? Here's what I believe in as a conservative federalist and how I can be called a conservative federalist. I believe in states' rights and states' determination. Not every political issue needs to be a dang federal case. Okay, come on. That's not the original intent of the Founding Fathers. Sure, we have Marbury Madison, Lee Madison, but I think a lot of these revisionist constitutional scholars, I don't think that they really understand what is the thing behind Marbury Madison, Lee Madison. If you want to know, I want you to study the case itself. And don't look at what the scholar is. You can look it up. They're at Cornell Legal Institute, I think, has a database online for Supreme Court cases for you to look at. But here's the thing. States' rights. Fair market capitalism. Less political wrangling. Okay? Please. Let's wake up and see reality. Please. If we as conservatives quibble over issues, then we're giving in to the leftists. Now, I'm not saying compromise on principle. No, I'm not saying that. But if we used to become so fanatical that we turn every political issue into a federal case, then what are we doing? We're becoming mamby-pamby. Why, I'm so offended. Grow up. Man, I get so fed up with that. That's why I consider a Federalist conservative. Now, I vote my certain way in my state, which right now, to be honest with you, the closest thing to take us away from socialists is the Republican Party. And some people say, well, these populists, they're taking over things. Well, let me ask you something. I think some of these people would prefer that career politicians take over things that are what is known as milquetoast conservatives. What happened to the rugged thought of the Founding Fathers? Sometimes things are just idiotic. And the media just panders to it on both sides of the aisle. Sure, the James A. Hendricks School of Leadership will not. I hope you enjoy listening to the James A. Hendricks School of Leadership. If you like what you hear, please subscribe. Become a part of the James A. Hendricks School of Leadership. Until next time, keep up. Please keep up your faith. I want you to please keep up your hope. I'm gonna tell you this right now. This one thing you need to put down in your bottom of your soul. Jesus saves, and we're all going to be okay. Take care and be proactively informed. Remember this from the bottom of my heart. Jimmy loves you. I really, 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 really love you. God bless you and have a blessed day.